year. Now, a huge part of the cinematic world's success hinges on movie trailers, but sometimes the previews can be misleading, confusing, or just plain boring. Now, one team decided that trailers should be a true reflection of movies. I spoke to one of the creators of Honest Trailers about his witty take on the film industry.
So the Honest Trailer started with Star Wars The Phantom Menace.
From the billion-dollar jowls of George Lucas comes the chance to relive the biggest letdown in movie history.
I feel like everyone was so excited for that movie when it first came out. And so here, many years later, now with the history of knowing it wasn't that great of a movie, they were releasing this trailer for the 3D redo. And I just found it really funny because the trailer almost tricked me again, where they showed sort of the cool scenes of the movie, but they didn't show any of the Senate meetings and the council meetings and all the, you know, very boring, tedious stuff. And so the idea didn't trigger in my head of, well, what if we just did the Honest Trailer?
And get ready for an hour and a half of people standing in semicircles, council meetings, different council meetings, and sitting.
All the stuff that basically the audience hated and knew going in. And it really then spurred from there of, well, let's do this with Twilight and Titanic and figure out how would a movie really market it to the audience if it was honest.
Yeah, and that's what we love about Honest Trailers is that you're not sarcastic and mean. You're just pointing out these fascinating truths. Is it hard to strike that balance to be kind of brutally honest without being insulting?
Yeah, I mean, there's certain movies, like I remember Transformers 4.
A man fighting against all odds to sound intelligent.
That is a super simplex theater projector. It's very rare.
Who taught you how to solder a circuit? Me. That's what I do.
That was a really tough one for us because it was hard to not be mean because it is what it is. It's a giant, chaotic toy commercial without much, you know, you don't really know what's happening in this movie.
So get ready for another sequel that you hoped would be better, but instead shove the same exact thing down your gullible throat.
There are certain movies where it's like, I don't think we're being mean. I think that movie, you go, you turn your brain off, and you watch robots rolling around, and you're not sure which robot's rolling on or who. But, you know, it's popular, so we call it out for what it is.
Do you have a favorite Honest Trailer?
Probably, I've been asked this a bunch now, it's tough, but one of the hardest ones was when we started doing the first good movie, and I would say it was back when we did, like, The Dark Knight and Avengers.
Battle so action-packed.
Stark, you got a lot of spray sniff in your tail.
You won't even ask yourself, how are they even all talking to each other without earpieces?
I can close it. Can anybody copy?
Do it! No, wait. Stark, these things are still coming.
And so those, to me, were sort of successes in my eyes because we were able to sort of take a good movie but not feel like we were just nitpicking it and bashing it for no reason. So I'm proud of those early ones because it helped us keep, it really helped pave the way for the show.
Jurassic Park 3D. Oh man, what an awesome shot. Oh, look at how the banner falls. I gotta watch this movie again.
We love these movies. We're not trying to just tear them apart and be mean. There are a couple movies we've done that too, but overall it's really about, we just want to give, you know, our hearts of the movies that we love to, you know, be shown.
And that was Andy Signore from Honest Trailers. Now, his team's brutally honest descriptions are so popular that the directors of Captain America Winter Soldier said that they tried their best to Honest Trailer proof their film. Now, the result